Good morning students, today we are continuing with the module 2 of motion in one dimension chapter. So let's begin our today's lesson. So the topic which we are going to start is acceleration. Now what actually acceleration is? Acceleration is rate of change of velocity with time. So acceleration is nothing but change in velocity by time. We already know this, and I have told this also while telling you the derived quantity acceleration, its derivation, its formula. It is a vector quantity, you will remember. The SI unit of acceleration is, since see the definition, you will not mug up these units, you will always try to derive. Now see the formula, acceleration is change in velocity by time. So it is actually velocity by time. So unit will be velocity by time. And what is the unit of velocity? It is meter per second. So I am writing meter second inverse, that is meter per second. By what is the unit of time? It is second, right? So we can write meter. This second inverse will go down and will become second into this second is already there. So meter per second into second is second square. So unit of acceleration is meter per second square, or you can write meter second minus 2. Next is C. Uniform acceleration, the terms which you have to know. Now uniform acceleration is if there is equal change in velocity takes place in equal time interval. So then the acceleration is said to be uniform acceleration. For example, if you throw a stone, it will fall under gravity, and there will be equal change in velocity in every equal time interval. So that is the uniform acceleration. So next is non-uniform acceleration. Non-uniform acceleration is if the change in velocity is not same in same time interval. For example, you are driving a car in a crowded road. Now sometimes you are getting a free space, then you are increasing your velocity in particular time interval, and again your velocity is eventually getting decreased because of the crowd. So the velocity is not maintained uniformly in equal time interval. So that is called non-uniform acceleration. Now acceleration due to gravity is very common term when a body falls freely, right? If you will throw a body, it will fall freely. And the acceleration produced in the body due to Earth's gravitational attraction. So that is called acceleration due to gravity, and it is denoted by small g. And its value is also 9.8 fixed, you have to remember. Now next is retardation. Now retardation is what? Retardation is negative acceleration, right? Now suppose you are driving a car with some velocity. Now you have to apply a brake in the running car. Now even after application of the brake, the car will slow down and will cover a few distance with acceleration, and it will come to rest at zero. It will get slowed down. So that slow motion means acceleration, which comes under the application of applying brakes, is called retardation. It is actually nothing but negative acceleration. Let us see some numericals based on this. Now see, a body starts from rest, acquires a velocity of 10 meter per second. The question given. A body starts from rest, acquires a velocity of 10 meter per second, find the acceleration. Now see, you will always write the given data while doing the numericals in physics. It is said that the body starts from rest. It means its initial velocity, u. U is called initial velocity is 0 because it is in rest. And it is acquiring a velocity of 10 meter per second, that is final velocity which it is acquiring, that is 10 meter per second. And in time 2 second, it is given in the question. So acceleration is nothing but rate of change of velocity. Acceleration is what? Rate of change of velocity. We have already learned the definition. So rate of change of velocity. Change of velocity means final velocity v minus initial velocity u. This is called the change in velocity. by time. This rate means by time. So final velocity given is how much? 10 minus initial velocity is how much? 0. And what is the time taken to do is 2 seconds. So 10 minus 0, that is 10. 10 by 2 gives you 5 meter per second square is the unit of acceleration just now we have derived. Now see next. A train moving with uniform speed covers a distance of 120 meter in 2 seconds. Calculate the speed of the train. First question. Next is the time it will take to cover 240 meter. Now students, a very damn easy question, basic question. Speed equal to distance by time. We all know, you know the mother formula, distance equal to what? Speed into time. Distance equal to speed into time. So what is the formula of speed? Speed will be distance. This is distance, you bring this time down. So speed will be distance by time. So speed is distance by time. So distance is given how much? It is given 120 meter, the train is covering distance 120, and in what time it is taking for that? 2 seconds. So by 2, you cancel, you will get 60. 120 by 2, that is 60. Now since it is speed, the speed unit of speed is meter per second, right? Now we have already got our speed. We will utilize this speed in our next part. Now next, it is telling the time it will take to cover 240 meter with this speed. So again, time is equal to how much? See the mother formula, distance equal to speed into time. So what will be time? Your time will be distance, you bring the speed down, distance by speed. So you apply the formula, time is equal to distance by speed. So distance given 240 meter, speed 60, which we have already calculated from here. Put the value over here, 240 by 60, you cancel this. 24 will be cancelled by 6 and you will get 4 second is the required answer. So students, please keep watching this video, start studying, don't waste your time. This is a crucial time, utilize it. Thanks for watching this video. This is Shagnik sir.